Hi guys, welcome to this video. In this video, I'm presenting about necessary steps to solve the problem using computer or using programming language. There are two major steps involved in doing any program or using any programming language. You need to develop an algorithm or pseudocode. If you are comfortable with visual representation, then you can develop a flowchart. It is mandatory to write an algorithm or a flowchart before coding or before doing a program using computer or programming languages. Let me state what is the meaning of an algorithm or pseudocode. Algorithm or pseudocode is a blueprint to do a program or to do a coding. What is the meaning of blueprint? In civil engineering, before the building construction, civil engineers used to draw a blueprint of the building. They will draw a blueprint of the building with the measurements, with each and every tiny details. It's an example for blueprint. It's a mental picture. It's an idea. It's a thought process. Whereas the algorithm is to be written in English or natural language. Flowchart is to be done with a diagrammatic representation. Universally, there is a fixed symbols or day to represent various stages of the program or various steps of the program. And let me give you one more example for algorithm. If you want to make a trip, picnic trip to an abroad, you will be doing with each and every step, sequence of steps, will be noting it down on a paper. When to apply visa, what is the procedure to apply visa, when to book the ticket, and what is the procedure to book the flight ticket, and when you are visiting each and every places of that particular country, and when you will be returning, what is your return arrangements, you will be writing it down. It's a complex process. So you will be writing it down on the paper for the mental clarity, so that it's easy to fix the timeline, it is easy to execute, it is easy to do the job with people's support or by yourself. It is like that. Algorithm is to solve a problem with different steps, different procedures using a computer programming or computer language. Let us see one by one. What is an algorithm? It's a step-by-step instruction for solving a problem. It must be precise. Algorithm itself does not solve the problem. It is a series of steps to solve the problem, to find the solution, to find the answer with the support of program and coding or by the computer. All the algorithms are need to be translated using computer programming language. Initially, you are expected to write an algorithm in English, natural language. It is independent of the computer language. We no need to rely on any of the computer programming language. We no need to refer any programming language to write an algorithm. It's a step-by-step procedure to solve a problem. It's a step-by-step thought process to write it down on the paper in a normal language or in an English. When we can say the algorithm is a valid or right one or correct one, when any algorithm, it follows four steps, major steps or major property, then we can declare the algorithm is right or valid. It must be unambiguous. Every step should be free from bias, free from confusion. Computer cannot think of taking multiple decisions. It will go one by one in a sequential way of executing, in the sequential way of doing the task, to perform the task. It must be executable. Anything which we mention in English, it must be capable to translate it in an computer programming language. Order. What is the flow of arranging all the steps. It must be free from ambiguous. The flow of steps should go one by one. The result of the first step should support the second step to start the job. The result of the second step should support the third step to start the job. It and so on. It must be like this. And it should have the termination point. Any algorithm must terminate. It should not be in the infinite loop. It should have the clarity, starting point, ending point. Between starting point to ending point, it must have the property called unambiguity, bias-free statements, bias-free instructions, and every step should be executable. All the steps are to be arranged in an order for the best result. What is algorithmic thinking? Given the problem, any programmer or coder able to understand the problem in detail, able to write an algorithm in English or in natural language, able to execute or able to translate the written algorithm in a programming language, and able to evaluate each and every step, whether the step one is right or not, why it is right, how it is right, why it is wrong, how you can correct it. You must be able to evaluate the result or expected task to be done by each of the line. These are all the expected or desirable qualities to become a good algorithmic thinker. Algorithmic thinking requires patience because each instruction must be executed in its correct sequence. None of the step to be skipped. None of the step to be added excessively. Neither it should be reduced nor it should be excessive. In addition, algorithmic thinking requires thoroughness of the particular problem, expected input, expected output. Determination is the desirable quality of the programmer. It's often tedious to follow the steps of the complex algorithm. Sometimes people fail and give up. Never give up. Focus on the problem. Try again and again to be successful. Why algorithms are important? With the support of algorithm or by writing an algorithm, we will come to know how to solve the problem, how part is addressed to a particular problem or to solve a particular task. If the algorithm is well written, it can be used in translating it into computer programming. It could be automated easily. It could be performed by a computer. The automation of some tasks makes new things possible. For example, accessing web pages from all over the world in a second, it is possible. Web crawling. Recent days, it is possible to pull the data from multiple websites using program. Before program, we must develop an algorithm. What is a step-by-step procedure? Which are all the steps or which are all the statements we are going to use? Which language we are going to use? Some methodology is to be arrived to solve the problem before implementing the coding or program. That is called algorithm. Let us look into the important properties of an algorithm. For any given set of related tasks, there are many possible algorithms for accomplishing the task. In our day-to-day life, to complete any task, let us take an example, event management. The way in which I organize the event and conduct the event and execute the event will be different from someone else. Everybody thinks in different way. Similarly, depending upon your thought process, your capability of thinking, your expertise, all determines the way of writing an algorithm. An algorithm does not encode the underlying theory behind the instruction steps. We no need to worry about the theory behind it. Just we can write find the square root of A and B. find log of A and B, we no need to worry about underlying theory. We can just write in a simple English. Some algorithms are more efficient than other algorithms, depending upon the thinking capacity, which I mentioned earlier. Algorithm must be independent from the programming language, but every algorithm must be in the position to translate or convert it into program or coding or programming language. Next, finally, to conclude, algorithm is a step-by-step instruction that performs a specific task or operation. Algorithm must be written in natural language, not in a programming language. Algorithm, otherwise called pseudocode. There are two terminologies used in this computer science world. Set of instruction that mimic programming language or programming instruction are said to be pseudocode. Keep watching. Now we are going to look at flowchart. What is the meaning of flowchart? How to draw a flowchart? How to use it? What is the meaning of flowchart? These are all the points to be discussed in the forthcoming part of the video. A flowchart is a type of diagram that represents an algorithm, workflow, or the process, or how the input is taken to the task and how it is performed, the process, and how the output is produced. It's a visual representation of an algorithm. It's a visual representation of an algorithm. These are all the symbols need to be used in the flowchart. Number one, this arrow mark, it's to depict or to indicate the flow line. First step to the second step, connecting consecutive steps using this arrow, we need to do logical connection or connecting each and every symbols which are all represented, which are all used in the flowchart. This symbol, ellipse symbol, is used for termination, start or stop. It's used to represent both start of the flowchart, end of the flowchart, or start of an algorithm, end of an algorithm. Parallelogram, this is a symbol, parallelogram is used to represent input operation, output operation, read operation, write operation, or what is the input need to be fed to the program, what is expected display from the program. Then rectangular symbol, it is used to represent the processing, to do calculation, to do operation. These are all the processing can be represented using rectangle. Diamond symbol, this is a symbol used to represent decision making. If this is right, what to be done next? If this is wrong, what to be done next? Decision making. If this is equal to 1, what to be done? If this is equal to 2, what to be done? If this is equal to 3, what to be done? If today is Monday, what to be done? If today is not Monday, what to be done? It is to represent either or type, yes or no type, decision making. Circle, simple circle is used to join different flow line. And on page connector, this symbol is used to connect flowchart, used to connect flowchart portion on different pages. You may not be able to complete it in a single page. You may require to complete the flowchart drawing in the next page. Then it is used to represent continuity of the flowchart in the next page. Let us see one example. This is the way you need to draw a flowchart. There's no logic behind this flowchart. Start symbol, start terminator, ellipse symbol, process, rectangular, decision making, this diamond symbol. If the decision is true or yes, what to do? If the decision is wrong or no, false, what do? This is a connector symbol as I mentioned earlier. Instead of mentioning here, simply it is given the connector. The same connector is represented here. That means if the decision is wrong or no, the flow should go to here. If the decision is right, the flow should go here as well as here. This is a circumstance. Sometime you may need to execute both of the line. Now, if it is yes, the flow comes to the terminator or end or stop situation. If the decision is wrong or no or false, it comes to this step, it skips the data part step and it does the document and end terminator. Now let us see an algorithm and a flowchart for sum of two numbers or addition of two numbers, a simple calculation. Algorithm, how you need to write? Step one. If you wish, you can write step one, or simply you can write number one, start. Number two, accept two numbers or read two numbers, input two numbers, any word you can use depending upon the versatility of using English or depending upon your thought process. Third step, perform addition of two numbers, calculate sum of two numbers, anything you can write. Fourth step, display sum as a result. Write sum, display result, anything you can write. Stop. It's a simple way of writing an algorithm. Now let us look into a visual representation of the same algorithm. It's called flowchart. To start, this is the symbol we need to use. Next, it's a rectangular symbol that shows declare variables number one, number two and sum. Then next, it's a parallelogram symbol. It's used to read number one and number two. And it's a rectangular symbol to do a calculation. Sum is equal to A plus B. It's represented reverse arrow mark. There is no equal to, because it's an algorithm. We can use in our own way of writing. Or you can even write perform addition of two numbers. A mere English you can write. Display sum, again parallelogram, stop. It's a flowchart for sum of two numbers. It's an algorithm for sum of two numbers. Let us look into one more flowchart. Draw a flowchart to input two numbers from user and display the largest of two numbers. You will be giving two numbers input. For example, 50 and 100. If I ask you which is largest number, you will say simply it's 100 is the largest number. Now, how you use your thought process to say the answer rightly, the largest of two numbers, 50 and 100 is 100, we are going to draw a flowchart for the same matter. Start, input number one, input number two. If you wish, you can write it in a single parallelogram, input number one, comma number two, or input number one and number two. Choice is yours. Next, decision making process. If the number 1 is greater than the number 2, 50 is greater than 100. In this circumstance, as I mentioned an example in the beginning, here also I'm considering the same example, 50 and 100. Number 1 is 50, number 2 is 100. If it is true, it goes and says number 1. If it is false, it says displays number 2. In this considered example, 50 and 100, 50 is not at all greater than 100. Then the condition becomes failed. Then it is represented as false case. Then the false case comes to this position. Then it is called display number 2. It will display for this circumstances 100 as an answer. Then the flow comes from false or the flow comes from true. It connects in a single point. Then it goes to the stop condition, termination condition. Now we are going to look at an algorithm to find whether the given number is even or odd. What is even All the numbers which are all multiples of 2 are, in simple term, if it is divisible by 2, those are said to be even number, otherwise odd number. Example for even numbers: 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, etc. Example for odd numbers: 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, etc. Now let us look into the algorithm. Step number 1, start. Step number 2, read n or input n. Anything you can write. Next, here you need a decision, or do the processing, then you can take decision making. If n reminder, you can use instead of this percentage symbol reminder, or calculate reminder. If the reminder is equal to 0, you can write, or you can say that it's an even number. Else you can say or display or write odd number. Stop. Now let us look into the flow chart for the same case. Find whether the given number is even or odd. Start. Parallelogram used for reading the input. Here in this case, only one input, n. Find the remainder. Dividing by 2. If the remainder is equal to 0, if the remainder is equal to 0 means true, then you need to write or display or print even number. If the remainder is not 0, it could be anything other than 0, then you need to display false, write odd number. Then both of the flow connection comes to stop. In the earlier case, we have seen the circle. From the circle, it had come to stop. If you want, you can use this method of doing the flow chart. If not, you can do like this. Both are logically correct. The way of thinking, the way of doing. Now draw a flow chart to find the largest among 3 different numbers. Earlier case, we have seen largest among 2 different numbers. This case we are looking into largest of 3 different numbers. Start, declare variables A, B and C, read input A, B and C parallelogram symbol. First you are taking a decision making upon 2 number. Through your thinking process, you can quickly say the answer among 10, 50, 100. Let us say A is equal to 10, B is equal to 50, C is equal to 100. Among these 3 numbers, which is the largest? Easily, quickly, you can say 100. But we need to make the same thinking process by the computer. We need to make the computer to think or take decision. Then it is little bit tedious. We need to make the computer to understand things. So for that, we need to go step by step. The very first step, we are considering only 2 numbers. Taking 2 numbers, find out whichever is greater. That greater number need to be compared with third number. Then you will come to know quickly and easily which is the largest among all the 3 numbers. Look at this step. A is greater than B. Is A is greater than B? Decision making. Yes. If A is greater than B, in this scenario, keep in mind 10, 50, 100. A is 10, B is 50, C is 100. 10 is not greater than 50. Then false condition is executed. It comes here. B is 50, C is 100. Is 50 is greater than 100? False condition. Then it prints B is greater than C. It is 50 is not greater than C. B is not greater than C. Then it is false. It comes to this flow line. It prints C. 100 is the largest number. This is how the flow goes. There are 3 decision making steps involved in this flowchart. Every decision making will have two lines, two paths. One is the path false, another one is the path true. If it is false, what need to be done? If it is true, what need to be done? That is the decision process. This I have explained with one simple example, 10, 50 and 100. You can interchange. Consider A as 50, B as 100, C as 10. What will happen? You try this. Try the analysis. Try the flow of execution or flow of analysis. But whatever the decision it does, all the decision, all the steps connects to the stop stage. An algorithm must stop. A program must stop and terminate. Next, one more flowchart to find roots of a quadratic equation. You know the quadratic equation. The highest polynomial order is 2. Whenever the highest polynomial order is 2, then it is scientifically or mathematically called as quadratic equation. Start. To solve this quadratic equation, how many inputs required? A is one input, B is one input, C is one input. A, B, C, declare variables, and D is to find out discriminant, and X1, X2 are to find out roots, real part and imaginary part. When the roots are real, but the determinant is less than zero or negative. Totally, you would require 8 different variables to complete a flowchart or algorithm or a program. This is a step to calculate discriminant. D is equal to, this is arrow mark, B square minus 4AC, not a square root, simple B square minus 4AC. That is given or assigned to the variable capital D. Decision making is happening here. If D is greater than or equal to 0, two cases, greater than or equal to 0, what to do? If D is not greater than or equal to 0, false condition, what to do? True condition, what to do? If it is true, then what it does mean? The roots are real and it has two different roots, unequal roots. Then you need to calculate root 1, R1 is equal to minus B plus square root of the determinant all together to be or need to be divided by 2A. Minus B minus square root of capital D all together need to be divided by 2A. The other part, let us come. If the discriminant equal to 0, there is no imaginary part at all. Only we need to go for the real part. So we need to calculate imaginary part equal to minus B divided by 2A. Real part is equal to square root of minus of D divided by 2A. Then two different roots are represented with conjugating variable plus I or plus J. RP plus J, IP, real part and imaginary part. Then next is RP minus J, IP, real part and imaginary part. Display R1, R2, stop. To learn more, you can visit these all the URLs. I'll mention these all URLs in the description box. Thank you for watching. Keep learning, enjoy learning.